Hello children, welcome to our science chapter number 12, friction. And in this chapter till now we have learnt about force of friction, or we can call that as frictional force, cause of friction, factors affecting friction, three types of friction, namely static, sliding and rolling friction. Then in last session we have learnt about friction a necessity, that is advantages of friction, and friction an evil or nuisance, that is disadvantages of friction. And coming to advantages of friction, we have learnt friction is used to walk on the ground properly, to write and draw on paper, to pick up and hold things in our hands, to light a matchstick, and many more advantages. And in disadvantages of friction, we have learned why, due to friction, the soles of our shoes gets wear away, tires of vehicles also wears out gradually due to friction, and friction, due to friction, brake pads, which is used in vehicle to increase the friction, gets wear out gradually, and it also wears out, friction also wears out the steps of staircases, which purposely made rough to increase the friction so that we can move properly, and it gets wear out in buildings and footover bridges, and the surfaces become smooth, so it is very dangerous for us, we cannot move properly over them. And as we have learned about advantages and disadvantages of friction, as we know that friction is used for us in many ways, that is, we can see that athletes and other sports persons, when they play, they often make use of friction. The same way gymnasts often apply some coarse substances like chalk powder on their hands. Why do they do so? By doing so, they increase the friction between their hands and the bars so that it gives them a better grip. So here we can see that for the method of increasing the friction, we can increase the friction by our own way. Here these athletes and other sports person, they purposely increase the friction, and gymnasts, they increase the friction of their hand by applying some coarse substances like chalk powder in order to get better grip. And this, now we'll be learning about different methods of increasing friction. So whenever friction is required, it is increased by making the surfaces rough. And this why? For this we will see one example, the sole of our shoes. Why? If you see, the sole of our shoes is grooved. Why the sole of our shoe is grooved? You can see in the picture, grooves of shoes, the sole of shoes. It is grooved in order to provide better grip on the floor so that we can move safely. If the surface, if it is grooved, the surface become rough, so that the contact between the sole of our shoes and floor get increased. That is, rough surfaces always they have that interlocking of, we have learned, ridges and grooves, which cause this friction so that we can move safely. And in the same way, brake pads are also used in brake system of automobiles and cycles. Why brake pads are used? Because to increase the friction so that brakes can work in an effective way. Brake pads are used in brake system of vehicles because due to brake pads, it increase the friction so that brake can work effectively. That is, when we apply the brake, due to brake pad, the force of friction will be more so that the vehicle can stop immediately. And now we have learned the advantage, that is how, what are the different methods to increase the friction? Mostly friction is increased by making the surface rough. Now sometimes this friction becomes undesirable for us as it reduces the efficiency of machines. And the same way, the friction, how it can be increased by making the surface more rough, and the same way it can be, whenever it is undesirable for us, the friction can be reduced by making the surfaces smooth. So friction, whenever it is undesirable for us, we can reduce the friction by making the surface smooth. Whenever we want friction, friction method to increase the friction is to make the surface rough. The same way, whenever friction is undesirable for us, friction can be decreased by making the surfaces smooth. How can we make the surfaces smooth? First method, that is friction, can be reduced by polishing the surfaces or by applying or putting lubricants on the surface or by using ball bearings in machines to reduce the friction. That is, friction can be reduced by making the surface smooth. How will make the surface smooth? By polishing the surface or by applying lubricants or by using ball bearings. Like you may have seen in even your skating shoes, the wheels, it has ball bearings because it reduces the friction so that you can skate easily. Now we'll be learning this one by one, or you can, that is, converting into wheels. Most of the suitcases, what we used to carry, heavy suitcases, if you see, they have wheel. Why do the suitcases have wheel? We prefer suitcases with wheels because when we pull it, we can easily, because of the wheels, that is rolling friction. Rolling friction, as we have learned, that it has very less friction so that we can move the suitcases easily. So converting into wheels is also one method to reduce friction. And you can see here the surfaces, by polishing the surfaces before this applying paint or by varnishing, we can polish the surface so that friction can be reduced. And now we will be learning about what is lubrication. Lubrication is a method to reduce friction. That is, a substances which help to reduce friction, we call that as lubricants. So what are lubricants? Substances which help to reduce friction are called as lubricants. And these lubricants, either it can be in a liquid forms like oils. Oil is also one lubricant. Semi-liquid form like grease is a lubricant. Or in a solid form like talcum powder are used as lubricants. And these lubricants are used to reduce friction. And children understood what are lubricants. Lubricants are substances, either it may be in solid form like oils, semi-liquid form like grease, or liquid form like oils, semi-liquid form in like grease, and solid form like talcum powder to reduce friction. And now we'll see why oil and grease are applied on moving part of machine. When oil and grease is applied, it forms a thin layer on the moving surfaces. So when oil and greases are applied, it forms a thin layer on the parts so that the moving surfaces do not directly rub with each other. And because of that, they do not rub, the interlocking can be unlocked easily. It can be avoided so that the machine parts can move easily. So if the machine parts, they move with each other, friction, if it is move up along with up, move against with each other, what happens? There will be more friction. The efficiency of the machine will be spoiled. So if you apply a thin layer of oil or grease on the machine surface, what happens? The moving surfaces do not directly rub against each other. If the because the oil, it unlock the interlocking between the ridges and grooves of both the surfaces, so that friction can be avoided to the great extent. And the same way, we sometimes apply oil on the hinges of the door because it reduces the friction so that it can open, the doors can be opened smoothly. And talcum powder, this is in solid form of lubricants, talcum powder. Before we play this carom board, this we will sprinkle talcum powder on carom board, because when powder is sprinkled on carom board, it smoothens the surface, like polishing the surface. And because of that, the friction between the stagger and the board get reduced, so that the stagger move easily, smoothly. That is why we sprinkle talcum powder. Again, when powder, talcum powder or boric powder, when it is sprinkled on the carom board, it reduces the friction because of smoothening the surface and the stagger move smoothly. And why were this solid, semi-liquid and liquid form of lubricants we have learned? And the same way, compressed, gaseous form, compressed and purified air can also be act as a lubricant. And if it is used, that purified air is used, it provides an elastic cushion between the moving parts, that it reduces the friction. And other than this, it has also have an added advantage of preventing dust and dirt from collecting on the moving parts. If you apply oil, grease, etc., what happens? Dust can be easily stick to that oil or grease. On the other hand, if compressed or purified air is used as a lubricant, what happens? It reduces the friction as well as it prevent dust and dirt getting collected on the machine parts. So, children, we have learned lubricants can be in any state, liquid state, like oil, semi-liquid state like grease, solid state like talcum powder, boric powder, etc., as well as gaseous state like compressed and purified air. And now we'll be learning about fluid friction. And fluids, that is when, what do you mean by fluids? The substances whichever flow from the word flow, fluid, as that is liquid also flow easily, as well as the gases also flow easily. So fluid means it includes both liquids and gases. And like solids, fluids also exert force of friction on an object which moves through them. So this fluid friction is called as drag. So like solid, when a ball is moved on the ground, here the ground is a solid surface. There we already learned it is a frictional force, the opposing force which opposes the relative motion of an object which moves over the surface of another object. The same way, when an object moves through a liquid here, it means fluid, moves through the fluid. Fluid means it includes both liquid as well as gases and is called as fluid friction. Again, what is fluid friction? Force of friction which exerted on the object when it moves through the fluids like liquids and gases. So the force of is called as fluid friction. The force of fluid friction on an object in a fluid, it depends upon the nature of the fluid, shape of the moving object, and the speed of the moving object. With respect to the fluid, And if you see the speed of the object with respect to the fluid, when we swim in water, here as we swim in water, water is a liquid, so we can call this as a fluid. Here exertion of fluid friction exert here, and the speed, if more is the speed of the object, here more is the friction. And if you see that nature of the fluid, if you compare it with fluid, water and air, or you can compare between water and other fluid like viscosity, honey and all, here it depends upon, like that depends upon the nature of the fluid and shape of the moving object. The fluid friction also depends upon shape of the moving object. For example, if you crush the paper like ball, and if you throw it, and the same way if you take a sheet of paper and throw it, which paper, which object will come down? Because when you crush it, the contact between the, because of the shape, contact between the air and the, here air is a fluid, so we can, it creates a fluid friction because the sub, shape, the fluid friction will be less, so it reach the ground sooner than compared with the piece sheet of paper. Sheet of paper, the surface, this area is more, so the contact between the air and the sheet is more. Here it exerts more fluid friction. So this way it depends upon the shape of the object, nature of the fluid, and speed of the moving object. Speed of the moving object, here it we can tell that more the speed, more the frictional fluid friction. And again, shape of the moving object, again we can see that streamlined shape, streamlined body shape object can easily move in the fluid, in water as well as in air. That is why, by, you can see that streamlined shape. What do you mean by streamlined shape? Border in the middle and tapering at both the ends. And we know that by seeing bird's body is streamlined shaped, broader in the middle and tapering at both the ends, so that it can fly easily. How it can fly easily? Because of the streamlined shape, it reduces the frictional fluid friction, that is air, so that it can fly easily. By seeing the bird, man discovered, invented this aeroplane. Aeroplane body is also streamlined shaped, broader in the middle and tapering at both the ends. The same way, by seeing the fish, shape of the fish, fish shape also, if you see, broader in the middle and tapering at both the ends. And the same way here, it reduces the fluid friction, that is of water, so that it can swim easily. By seeing this, the shape of the boat or ship also have streamlined shape, that is broader in the middle and tapering at both the ends. So children, fluid friction, it depends upon the nature of the fluid, shape of the object, that is mainly streamlined shape, it causes less fluid friction, as well as the speed of the object. More the speed, it creates more fluid friction.